Harry S. Truman. He understood on a personal level what can happen when we allow the forces of evil, the forces of aggression, to spread. That experience left Truman, along with generations of men and women who survived the two world wars, determined that history would not repeat itself. Harry Truman believed that the best way, maybe the only way, to ensure that was to bind America's fate to that of other nations who shared our values, for all to commit to defending one another's territory as if it were their own. Now, those of us here today in some ways may take that for granted now after 75 years, but this was a radical belief in its time, and it was also an untested one. It required that the 12 founding members of the alliance, and then those who came after, not only to build the foundations of peace, but then to keep fortifying it, adapting those foundations as new challenges emerged. And for three quarters of a century, that's exactly what our alliance has done. And yet, that security, together with the alliance's core principles of democracy, of liberty, the rule of law, this is once again being challenged. Challenged by those who believe that might makes right, and those who would seek to redraw borders by force. We know many new challenges emerge, challenges that would have been unimaginable to NATO's architects, growing climate crisis, cyber attacks, disinformation. The alliance is meeting these threats as we always have, by adapting together. As Truman said at the founding, the purpose of this defensive alliance is to allow us to get on with the real business of life, the real business of government, the real business of society, achieving a fuller and happier life for all our citizens. Let us together protect all we've built in 75 years under NATO's shield and ensure that it remains strong to keep building for the next 75 years and well beyond that.